All right, so for GASB 87, the lessee has to recognize a lease liability. And like we talked about, this lease becomes a finance lease. So you're not just gonna recognize expense and cash and maybe deferred rent as you've been doing historically. This lease needs to be recognized as a liability. And per the guidance, specifically GASB 87, paragraph 21, the lessee initially should measure the lease liability at the present value of the payments expected to be made during the lease term. So if you recall from when we were talking about components, we had some payments, some base rent payments. The base rent payments were monthly. They were paid $3,200 a month. It was also noted that they were paid in advance or they were made on the first of each month. Similarly, we had some prepaid rent that was made. If you recall, at the execution date, the lessee made a prepayment for 2 months of rent or $6,400. So no rent is going to be due for those 2 months of August and September of 2021 due to that prepayment. And then when we think about the term, so what we need to do with these payments is we need to figure out what the present value is of those payments over that term. And so our term is actually 11 months, like Amanda talked about. It's going to be that first year. But we actually are having 8 monthly payments that are made from the periods of October to May because of that 2 month prepayment. So what we're going to do here is we're going to present value the payments that are made in the future at today using that borrowing rate, which Amanda just talked about for the lessee, which we weren't able to determine the implicit rate because we didn't know the inputs, assuming as a lessee, generally that is the case. So we are actually using that estimated incremental borrowing rate, and that was determined to be 7.2%. So if you are wondering how we're going to do this, a note, we do have a present value calculator tool on our website. That's what we used to come up with our liability calculation today. And so what you would do is just input the payment information and the term and the borrowing rate, and it gives you the measurement of the liability. So that's what we have done. We've plugged in our $3,200 payments over that 11-month term, actually making 8 payments at a 7.2% borrowing rate. And that's going to give us a present value of $24,626. Now, if you recall, this present value needs to happen as of the July 1st date, because that is when the lessee, or again, the school district, got early access to the building or the gymnasium from the city. So you would take the payments, present value them at that time, July 1st, and that also happens to be our transition date as well. All right, so next we're going to talk about the asset calculation. So first you come up with the lessee's lease liability. We came up with that $24,626. Similarly, you have to recognize an asset. And to do so, you would start off with the beginning balance of the liability. Now, if you didn't have any sort of adjustments, so like we talked about with our components, there were some things that we need to adjust for. If you didn't have any adjustments, in theory, your beginning lease asset would equal your lease liability. However, we had some adjustments we need to make. We had a prepayment. So that $6,400 was 2 months of rent that was paid at lease execution. That was for those 2 months of rent later on. And so this is actually going to be a reclass from that initial entry that I mentioned that we made in February, that we recognized a prepaid rent as a debit. So this is going to essentially be an addition here to our a liability. So we're going to add that in. Next, we had an incentive. The incentive here is going to reduce the liability to get us to the asset. And that was for $5,000. And that was received at commencement from the lessor. So it's going to be included in our calculation. Again, if you recall, if this was received after commencement, so it was still payable, it would be a reduction of the lease payments. So it would have been included in the liability as well. But because it was paid at or before the commencement, it's going to be just an adjustment to the lease asset. So taking our adjustments here, starting with the lease liability, adding back that $6,400 of prepaid rent and reducing it by our $5,000 cash incentive, we come up with our opening asset balance of $26,026. So what now? What do you do with that information? Well, you would need to make an amortization table for both the asset and the liability. So here in our screen, we have two screenshots. On the left-hand side, we've got the liability, and on the right-hand side, the asset. We're gonna start with the liability first. So we have the beginning balance. We just came up with that using our present value calculator tool. We put in our payments using the 7.2% interest rate, and we came up with a balance of our liability of $24,626. Again, this is at the transition date, which just so happens to be our early access date. $24,626 is our begabelle or beginning balance line. Now it's worth noting here that we've got this as a short-term liability balance. The reason for that is because our term is actually 11 months. So we are going to be settling this over the next 11 months. So it's going to be short-term, our short-term liability. So when we think about the other columns here, we've got the year and month, hopefully self-explanatory. And then we have the cash column here. The cash column, there are some periods where no cash payment is being made. So we've got periods where we are prepaying, but during those periods, you actually need to recognize interest. And so interest expense, because this is now a finance lease, we need to recognize interest accruing on the lease liability. So even in those periods where no payment is made, we're accruing interest. And so you'll actually notice that in the next month from our August and September, the liability actually goes up because no payments are made. Then we have October when our payments actually begin. And we have this highlighted here because we're actually going to be going through the entry for this October date, but that's when the cash payments begin. So you still recognize the interest expense in that period. But instead of actually increasing the liability through that accrued interest, you're going to take the difference between the cash and the interest to actually reduce the liability. And that's going to happen each period after October, as you'll notice, until the end of the lease, in which the liability balance is fully zero. So that's how you would set up the lessee's amortization schedule for the liability. Now, we didn't just have the liability. We also have an asset. And we started with the liability balance of $24,626, but we made our adjustments to come up with our initial asset balance of $26,026. So this $26,026 is our initial asset, and it's going to be depreciated over that term of 11 months. And we're using the straight line depreciation method in order to do so. So you would divide that asset value divided by the term to get $2,366. And so at the end here, our asset is going to be reduced. And then the October month, again highlighted here, is going to be our month that we are going to take a look at when we look at a subsequent entry. So again, that is the amortization schedule for the lessee. We're going to now talk about our journal entries for those as well. All right, so what are the initial journal entries? Well, upon transition, which we decided again was July 1st of 2021, the lessee needs to make an entry. And this entry is going to include the initial recognition of the asset and the liability. And so starting off with the same order that we went through today, we recognized first the value of the lease liability. So we took the present value of our payments and came up with a liability of $24,626. So liabilities have normal credit balances, so we're going to recognize this through a credit. And again, it's worth noting that this is a short-term liability because it's going to be reduced within 12 months. So that's the first step of our entry, is recognize that credit. On the other side, next we came up with the asset value, the $26,026. So we recognize this asset and it is slightly higher. So if we didn't do anything in the middle here, our entry wouldn't balance. And as mentioned a little bit earlier, if for some reason we didn't have any adjustments, this asset and liability would equal each other. So we would just have an entry to debit the asset and credit the liability. But in our example, we do. So our asset is $26,026, but we need to make the adjustments in this entry as well. So the two adjustments that we made were for a cash incentive and for prepaid rent. The debit to this cash incentive here is the incentive received from the lessor. Since it was received at commencement or before commencement, it's going to reduce that lease asset. So we're going to debit it. We also have a credit to prepaid rent. So if you recall, again, we made an entry back in February where we debited a prepaid rent and credited cash because we made that payment for that 2 months. So what we're doing here is reclassing, reversing out that prepaid rent balance by crediting it. And again, that's going to be basically increasing our value here. So all in all, this is our transitional entry. This is what you would do at transition, make those adjustments and recognize the asset and the liability. So what happens next? So we just looked at the July entry. What about the next entries? Well, we looked at the amortization schedule. I had highlighted that October month. And the reason for that was because that's when the first month of payment is actually made. Now, you still need to recognize entries in the previous months. Just a note here that in those months when payment isn't being made, you still need to recognize interest accruing. So you would debit the interest, but you would credit the liability. Just a note there. But we're talking about our subsequent entry for October because that's when our first cash payment is made. So let's go ahead and walk through that now. So the first item to follow is the easiest, and it's cash. So the lessee is making a payment here. So they're going to credit cash, and it's just 1 month that they're paying in October. So it's $3,200. So we're going to go ahead and credit our cash here. Next, if you remember from the amortization schedule, in addition to recognizing the cash payment, the lessee, because this is a finance lease, has to recognize interest expense on the liability. So the interest expense, if you calculate it for the month of October, it comes out to $150. So it's based on that 7.2% and the outstanding liability. That's going to be a debit because it is an expense. Now, the difference between the cash paid, $3,200, and the interest expense of $150 is going to be the reduction to the principal lease liability, in this example, $3,050 for this period. Again, it's short term because it's due in 11 months or 12 months or less. So we're going to have a reduction to our liability. That's the liability side. The asset side is pretty straightforward. Each period, after recognizing that initial asset, the lessee recognizes a straight line depreciation expense, which we computed to be $2,366. So they're going to debit the expense account for $2,366 and credit the accumulated depreciation for $2,366. So again, this would happen each month after this as well, but we just went ahead and went through one entry today on the lessee side for the subsequent entry.